Okay, now that we have finalized the drawing portion of our image, we are going to now focus on adding the value. Notice how light my drawing still is. We never want to outline anything that we want to turn into becoming three-dimensional, because outline will flatten the image and you'll lose the idea of form, and it will go more towards shape. Shapes are like cartoons. Lots of cartoons are outlined, and right now we want to focus on a three-dimensional realistic image on a two-dimensional surface. So we want to stray away from the idea of outlines. So nice soft drawing to start. Now I'm going to start to utilize all the pencils that I have. Remember, we created our value scales, and understanding that our B pencils are our darker value pencils because they have softer lead, and our H pencils are harder lead, therefore they are lighter on the paper. And you have your HB pencil right down the middle, which is what I used for the actual drawing portion of the bird. Higher the number with the B, the darker the pencil will be on paper, and then same thing with H, the higher the number with H, the lighter it will be, so going vice versa with darks and lights following the numbers. Alright, so I'm going to come in with a 2B pencil to start. I really want to focus on where I see darker values and lighter values. For me, with the idea of creating the feathers and the texture of the feathers, I'm going to be using the hatching method. Okay, so remember, with our hatching method, we made lines a bunch of times and lifted our pencil off the paper every time, so that's what I'm going to focus on. And not only am I going to do the hatching method, but I need to understand the direction of the angle of how I'm going to make my hatching marks. So on the top of the head, they kind of are a curled hatching method, flowing away from the beak, and then underneath the beak area, they're kind of more downward. So the direction of your marks will also help understand the idea of three-dimensionality and form, as well as the values of your lights and darks. So I'm going to come in with a nice sharpened pencil, and if you can see that, I'm just making a bunch of hatching marks in the direction of how I see the image, using darker pencils, lighter pencils to develop the areas of the lighter and darker values. So now I'm going to come in down here using the hatching method, making a bunch of marks, lifting the paper every time. My pencil off the paper every time. I notice that it is a lot lighter right underneath of the beak and the black portion on the head of the bird. So I'm going to kind of avoid that. If I want to just come in and make smaller little detailed textures with hatching, I'm just coming in with my 2H and develop a little bit of value there, just to reference the idea of the texture of the bird. Okay, so I'm going to go now just show you guys with my 4B, the beak. Beaks are going to be nice and smooth compared to the actual bird's feathers itself. So now, this is where I'm going to utilize multiple mark-making techniques to develop the picture that I'm looking at, or the object I'm looking at. So now, I'm going to come in and use a blending method with my 4B pencil to start on the bottom side of the bird's beak. For my bird, the darker value is on the bottom, and the lighter value is on the top, and that's telling me that the light source is coming from above. So now I can understand where the light source is coming from. Remember, on our previous assignment, we worked with that, with our basic shapes, understanding where the light source is coming from in order to figure out where the lighter portion of our object was. So same thing goes with the beak. The beak is like a cone. We break that idea of the beak down into a form, it would be a cone. So then we would understand that one side of the cone is going to be darker, and that's going to be the bottom side, and then the top side is going to be lighter. So I've came in with my 40, and then if I want to slowly work my way up using a blending method, I'm using a 2B now, blending it into the 4B, and I can transition to an HB. Work my way towards a lighter value there, towards the top of the beak. Okay. I do see there's a lot of darkness going on right here where the black portion of the beak meets the fur itself, so I'll come in and develop that darker value. So now I'm going to transition into that hatching method on the portion of the bird that is feathers now that are black. pencil, position my body and my arm in a way that is more comfortable for me with the blending method. Don't make this harder on yourself than it actually needs to be. Okay, I'm going to come in and develop some value within the eye. See all the values going throughout the entire eyeball to understand how dark or light I need to go and where I need to. All eyeballs are wet, and so they'll have a reflection on them. So you can definitely see that on the bird's eyeball towards the top. So I'll make sure it's a little bit lighter towards the top on my eyeball. Continue to develop all those values. Use different mark making techniques to accomplish exactly what you're looking at. Get a little bit darker on the bottom side of the beak. Start to once again pay attention to my values throughout the entire head. We're starting to get an idea of three dimensionality and value within the head of and the beak of the bird itself, and I'm going to continue to work on this and start another video based on that and showcase more ideas of how I'm going to develop the darks within the bird, focus on the lights, understand how to use my eraser as a mark making tool, so if I went a little bit too dark I can come back with my eraser and lighten things up. Erasers aren't only there just to fix mistakes, but also can be used as a mark-making tool, and then continue to further develop my bird itself.